Hi Marie, nice to meet you. I'm Howard and I've come to interview you.
Nice to meet you too, Howard.
So, Marie, can you tell me a bit about your early life and how you became interested in science?
I was born in Warsaw, Poland, in 1867. My father was a teacher of mathematics and physics, and my mother was a singer. I was the fifth and youngest child in my family. When I was 10, my parents died of tuberculosis, so I was brought up by my oldest sister, Bronia. I finished high school at the age of 15 and wanted to go to university, but at that time women were not allowed to study at Polish universities, so I had to go to Paris. I studied at the Sorbonne and in 1891, I obtained my master's degree in physics.
And what made you want to study physics?
I've always been interested in mathematics and science. When I was young, I used to do a lot of experiments at home. My father was also a big influence. He was always teaching us about science and encouraging us to ask questions.
So, you went to Paris to study physics. What was that like?
It was a very difficult time for me. I had to travel to Paris on foot, and as I was a woman, I was not allowed to stay in the men's dormitory at the Sorbonne. I had to find a private room, which was very expensive. I did not have any money. I was very lonely at that time. I was 22 years old and I did not have any friends. The professors at the Sorbonne were very friendly to me, but I was not allowed to have any contact with them. I was in a very difficult situation.
So, you met your husband, Pierre Curie, in Paris. How did that happen?
We met at the Sorbonne, where we were both studying physics. As I was not allowed to stay in the dormitory because I was a woman, I had to find a private room. I saw Pierre in the library and he was a very nice person. He used to give me books and taught me about chemistry. He was very kind to me. We got married in 1895 and had two daughters, Irena and Eve.
And you started working together on your research into radioactivity. Can you tell us a bit about that?
We began our research in 1896, after Pierre found a new element, which he named polonium, after my home country of Poland. We then discovered another new element, which we named radium. We spent a lot of time investigating the properties of these new elements and their radioactivity. In 1903, we were awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics, along with Henri Becquerel, for our work on radioactivity.
That's amazing. And you were the first woman to win a Nobel Prize.
Yes, that's right.
What was it like to win such a prestigious award?
It was a great honor, of course. But I must say, I was a bit surprised, as I wasn't expecting to win. I was very happy, though, as it meant that our work was being recognized. But it was also a bit bittersweet because my husband and I had won it together and he was no longer alive.
And you won another Nobel Prize in 1911, this time in chemistry. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, that was for our work on the isolation of radium. We developed a new method to purify the element, which was a big breakthrough.
So, you've won two Nobel Prizes, that's incredible.
Yes, it is. I feel very fortunate.
What do you think is the most important thing you've achieved in your career?
I think the most important thing is that we've helped to advance the understanding of radioactivity and its effects.
Do you think that having been a woman made it more difficult to lead your career?
Yes, it was definitely more difficult to be a woman in science. There were fewer opportunities and less support. But I was very lucky to have a supportive family and an understanding husband.
What was your experience like as a scientist during the First World War?
It was very difficult. I lost my husband and my daughter during the war. And my work was interrupted. But I was still able to contribute to the war effort by working on radiological methods to locate artillery shells.
What do you think of the current feminist movement?
I think it's very important. Women have been discriminated against for far too long and I think it's time for change. I'm glad to see more and more women becoming involved in science and other male-dominated fields.
What do you think is the most important issue facing women today?
I think the most important issue facing women today is equality. We need to be seen as equal to men in all aspects of life, whether it be in the workplace, in terms of pay, or in terms of social and political rights. Women are always considered to be weaker than men. This is not true. Women are as strong as men. I think it is important for women to be involved in science because it will help us in many ways.
If you knew that radioactivity was going to end up killing you, would you have done the same?
Yes, I would have done the same. Radioactivity is something that I'm passionate about, and I believe that the benefits of it outweigh the risks.
Do you believe that our existence is an illusion?
No, I don't believe that our existence is an illusion. I think that our existence is real and that we are all here for a reason.
Marie, are you aware that you are currently dead?
Yes, I am aware of that.
How do you feel about being dead?
Well, it's certainly different from being alive. It's a bit strange at first, but you get used to it.
What's it like being in the afterlife?
It's hard to describe. It's a bit like being in a dream, but you are aware of everything that is happening.
What do you miss the most about being alive?
I miss the people I loved and the things I did. I miss being able to interact with the world and experience new things.
What was the best thing about being alive?
For me, it was the opportunity to learn and to discover new things. I was always curious about the world and I loved finding out how things worked.
What are you most proud of in your life?
I am proud of my work.
Do you have any regrets in life?
I don't think so. I mean, I've done some things that I'm not proud of, but I don't really regret anything. I think everything happens for a reason.
What would you say is your greatest achievement?
I would say my greatest achievement is my discovery of radioactivity. It was a completely new field of study, and it was very exciting to be able to contribute to its development.
Do you believe in fate?
No, I don't believe in fate. I believe that we control our own destiny and that we can choose our own path in life.
What do you think is the most important thing for people to remember about you?
I think the most important thing for people to remember about me is that I was a great scientist and that I made important contributions to the field of physics.
What would you say to those young people who are eager to study science but are hesitant?
First of all, I would say that science is an amazing way to understand the world around us, and it can be a really rewarding career. I would encourage anyone who is interested in science to pursue it and not be discouraged by the challenges. It's worth it.
What message would you leave to the new current generations?
I would say to the new generations that it's so important to keep learning and investigating throughout your life. Science is constantly evolving and there is always more to learn. Never stop questioning and never stop learning.